Hey everyone, Sambat here. Today we are going to cover the Celestron Dew Heater. So if you ever had a situation where you had set up your entire imaging session only to find out in the morning that your imaging session is ruined by tiny droplets of water in the telescope mirror, you're not alone. This is a common issue and I've also experienced that. So to overcome the problem, you need to attach the dew heater and also manage the temperature of the dew heater properly. Fortunately, Celestron also has the solution for this, and you can use the Celestron dew heater, attach it to power box. I have done a video of power box in the earlier videos. You can refer to that. So we will connect the dew heater to the telescope, and then we will attach it to the power box today. Okay, I have the Celestron dew heater. I purchased this for HHD 9.25 inch. Celestron has the dew heater for 8.0 inch, 11.0, and as well as 14 inches. So check the Celestron site, and before you purchase it, make sure it's the right one for your telescope. So let's open this up and see what's inside. Okay, the box itself comes with the dew heater ring, a cable for connecting to the power box, and manual. This is the Instllation shield so that the mirror doesn't get damaged when you are removing the screws. This is the cable management clip, so we will just go through that in a bit. So contents are very simple. So let's attach this to the telescope and complete the setup. Okay, let's start attaching the dew heater to the telescope. To get started, first attach your telescope to the mount and then position it in a way it is vertical. So this is to easily handle the process of attaching the dew heater. So let's first open the telescope. So I have the 9.25 inch edge HD here. So notice a few things to begin with. There are six screws here that you have to remove. And then you also have to make sure that when you're doing it, don't make sure that the screws doesn't fall on the mirror and then scratch the surface. So to avoid that, Celestron has given the install shield. First place that over here. So even by mistake, you don't actually spoil the mirror. Okay, let me then start removing the screws. Keep the screws safely. You will need it to reattach the dew heater here. The dew heater does not come with the separate screws. Just make a note of it. Once you remove the screws, take out the ring. So you notice that there is a notch which is actually preventing the ring to come out easily. So let's try. Okay, a little bit of pressure, then it comes out. There are two gaskets. Remove them too. Okay, let's start installing the dew heater. So start aligning the notches that's present so it can actually go inside properly. Alright, so that's good. Now you can actually install the screws. So the easy way to actually do that is look for this label and position the label pointing towards the plus mini mount there. Okay, I had to admit that I had some problem with adding the screw here. So one thing that you need to be careful about is make sure that you position the ring and look at whether the hole is visible, and then actually insert the screws. I made a mistake, and then actually one of the threads got spoiled, but I have managed to actually place the screw back again, so all good here. But just to make sure visually see whether you're able to see the hole before you tighten anything in the Dew Heater ring. So let's continue with the other screws. So make sure you do it opposite sides and don't tighten everything at once. Okay, after installing all of the screws, this is the end result. So as I said before, there are six screws, right? So if you're wondering like where's the sixth screw, it's behind this. So remove that card and then you will see the hole here. So that's another thing to note. So that's the installation of the Dew Heater. And after you're done, you can remove the Dew install shield. It comes out. There you go. Just wanted to point out how to actually do the cable management. So as I mentioned before, it comes with a cable clip. Mount a cable clip, something like this, just push it and it'll go in, and take out both of the cables, and then you can just push them inside the ends pointing down, and that way, right, so it's not on the way of the light coming through the telescope. And so you can then connect the cable that came with the the Dew Heater, and then take the other end and connect it to the power box Dew Heater port. Okay, so that actually is all simple setup, and the telescope is now ready to go. Thank you for watching. Today we covered the Celestron Dew Heater. I hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Until then, have a great day and clear skies.